The 36th Annual Heritage Festival gets underway this weekend. Over 60 pavilions will be set up representing 85 cultures from around the world. Joining us today to talk about all of the events is the Executive Director of the Heritage Festival, Jack Little, and Antonella here with the Pavilion Coordinator for the Italian Pavilion. Jack, you're a familiar face at the Heritage Festival, and we're always excited. Edmontonians mark it on their calendar, but for anybody who hasn't been out there, why should they be out there this weekend?
Well, the excitement is there. There's no question about it. There's going to be at least 400 opportunities to eat and the same number of opportunities to see ethnic entertainment throughout the park. New country this year, and it's going to be Cuba, and maybe they're even going to be rolling some cigars. Cameroon is coming. They're a very small community, so they'll be under the Africa Pavilion. So all in all, a very exciting time. We just came from the park now, and it's looking absolutely awesome.
Always is. There's
a possibility we may even be ready for our opening.
Fantastic. Well, that's a bonus.
Yes.
And you're here, and Antonella's here to show us a little bit of a sneak peek of some of the things you can expect to see at the Italian Pavilion. Tell us about some of the artifacts that you've brought today and the importance of them.
Well, there are going to be a variety of artifacts at the pavilion because we have as many regions as we do. So we try to find as many artifacts within the community of different members of the community to offer them. So
this is beautiful.
This first piece is from the Liguria region. And in terms of the design and style, it's very distinct of a seaside area called Albisola Mare in Liguria region. And so they use these darker colors. The next one that's closer to the center, it's a soap dish, however, that particular style and coloring of soap dish is from Toscana, from Florence. And then the more unusual piece that we have in terms of the ceramics are the pine cones, and those come from Sicily. And pine cones are a traditional symbol of hospitality. So in many parts of Sicily, either on their balconies or at their front doors, you'll actually find pine cones on each side. Yeah, and in some cases on the balconies as well.
A very good example that it's much more than just the food. The food, very enjoyable, but there's much more for everyone to learn there besides just the food.
And exactly.
You'll have a lot of that too, I'm sure.
Yes, we do. In fact, we'll be.
Jack, what are some of the details, the hours? When can people start getting down there?
It all starts at noon on Saturday and goes right through until 7 o'clock on Monday. So it's all Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. There's a long day on Saturday. Then on Sunday, it starts at 10 o'clock and goes till 9 o'clock. And then it concludes on 7 o'clock on Monday, which is, of course, Heritage Monday.
It's going to be an action-packed weekend down there, and there's always a really exciting ceremony that happens there, the citizenship ceremony.
Yes, this will be the second year it's been brought back. There's going to be 126 people become new Canadians. Very emotional time. I sat through it last year. Very emotional time. For every person who comes, they bring family, and they're all dressed in native costume. And to see that Heritage Amphitheater full of all these wonderful costumes, it's very emotional. And to see what becoming a Canadian citizen means to these people is particularly of benefit, I think, for everyone to see. And it, of course, it is free. Everyone can come at 12 noon on the Monday.
And you know, everyone suggested to bring a non-perishable food item. We talked about that earlier in the show. But there's something we really need to mention quickly because it's just exciting. This year, the CTV Citizen of the Year Award.
Fantastic. The Citizen of the Year, as a matter of fact, I don't think I'm revealing any secrets.
No secrets.
But there are two Citizens of the Year have been selected by CTV. And they're going to have a major presentation at 2:05 p.m. right after the citizenship swearing-in ceremony. It will be the CTV Citizens of the Year. We're very excited about this, and we're very excited to partner with CTV on a very unique venture.
You know, there's going to be a weekend filled with fun, filled with food, and lots of things for everybody to do. The festival starts Saturday and runs until Monday at Horlock Park. There are over 60 pavilions. Public parking is not available. There's more information on our website, ctvedmonton.ca. Just click on News Links. Thank you guys so much for coming out. We will see you this weekend for sure.
Love to see you.